Yeah, good morning everyone. My name is Pratish Sanghvi. I run Grab. Grab is a last mile logistics company. We operate in 10 cities across the country. So we are a 3-year-old company. We started primarily as a logistics company supporting the food and the beverages outlet. Over the last 1 year, we have diversified into not just last mile, and I'll speak a little more about that later. That logistics in India is no longer just last mile. There are way too many components emerging out of these industries, which includes first mile, reverse. Some of the e-commerce companies now wanting even a more quicker and a more robust solution to these. So we manage multiple different verticals in logistics, and we are in 10 cities, and I'm here to talk a little more about how the impact to the urban markets, the rural markets, and how consumer expectations are changing because of these various options available.
Yeah, hi, my name is Ben Matthew. I manage the Asia business for Greenlight Planet. Greenlight Planet is an American solar lighting company. We make solar lanterns and home systems primarily for consumers who are either unelectrified, have power cuts of more than 3-4 hours, or are completely unelectrified, have no power at all. And we sell these products in about 50 countries now. We've sold about 5 million of these units over the last 7 years. These products range from 500 rupees entry level lantern to about 1900 rupees lantern which charges mobile phones as well, and home systems at about 5000 and 7000 bucks. So we've been selling these in most of these markets, and we work with partner organizations who have rural network and distribution. We have our own sales agents, village level entrepreneurs who are managed by our own employees. And we also work in the traditional retail distribution segment, where we appoint district level distributors who sell products to rural retailers.
Hi, good morning. I'm Paresh Rajate, founder of Suvidha. It's a financial services company. It's an 8-year-old company, and we have, on the one side, we integrate all the services which is required by the common man onto the platform, and on the other side, we have internalized the model where we reach out to the consumers through the retail network. So, we have a mom and pop stores or Kirana stores or a travel agent or a telecom guys. They become our franchisee, and the consumer walk into these outlets and avail the services. So we have about 300 odd service partners which services are integrated on our platform and reach it out. So you think of a payments like a bill payments, utilities, insurance, telecom, recharges, railway ticketing, airline, buses, and then we have been pioneered in few of the things. So today if you go and buy the railway ticket from a travel agent, which is a B2B, that was innovated by us. We went to the railway, explain them the use case and how that can benefit to the people. And that's how we were first to connect that, operationalize, run that business for about a year, monopoly exclusively. And based on the success, they give it to the other people. The change or disruption, it happens that from 1500 locations where these tickets were available at the stations across India, which the railway was enabling that, today it is available at 150,000 locations in India, across India. So that has changed the game differently. In 2011, again we disrupted the market in the domestic remittance. So today if you see the remittance play, which is a money sent by migrant from the urban to the rural, the whole service was innovated by us, and we do it. Saying that, at the size point of view, we are about 90,000 outlets across India. Our presence is about 2,800 towns and cities. We do about 40 million transactions a month, a year, and at the run rate of about 10,000 crore worth of transactions. We have about 35 million unique consumers on our platform who come and avail the services. So this is mainly meant for the two kind of points. So the people who cannot transact online, who needs the assistance, and who wants to transact by cash. So these are, and if you know that these are both figures are more than 90% of the population who can't transact online, or almost 95% of the retail transactions are still in the cash. So if you consider these two things, that's where we address the segment of customers.
Morning, everybody. My name is Riyaz, and I represent a company called Connect India. We are a bridge between the urban and rural India, and we are a bridge between the urban India itself, because urban India itself logistically is completely divided. What we do is we do what Mr. Paresh was talking about in terms of services, we do with physical products. We use a similar infrastructure, existing assets of a shopkeeper to create last mile delivery for physical products. Why we do? Because we believe that the issue of last mile cannot be addressed in a B2B framework or into the current B2C framework which is being done by the e-commerce industry. How we go about doing it is we keep it simple and we base entire model on trust. As to why we do it on trust is because of the fact that Mr. Vijay Mahajan, the founder and the gentleman behind microfinance and a lot of inclusion stuff that happens around in India, is a part promoter in this company. And our experience in microfinance brought us to see the reality that last mile logistics is a very, very big challenge in the country. What have we done since the last 1 year, since we've formed as a company? We moved from 0 to 8,000 outlets in 8 months. We moved from 0 to 20,000 shipments a day in 6 months. To just give you a comparison, Delhivery, which is the largest e-com last mile delivery dedicated company, took 4 years to move from 0 to 100,000 shipments a day. The scale we have and the opportunity that we have is exciting the entire e-commerce industry, but we believe that real logistics is beyond e-commerce. It's actually connecting India to India, from villages to the urban markets and to the international markets. And we partner with United Parcel Service, a very large and the largest express company in the world, to connect a lot and lot many parts of India to the rest of the world. So we're creating a distribution revolution. For you to understand it a little more simply, is we are what Airtel did to BSNL, what Amul did to Milk Revolution, is what we do to India Post. Thank you very much.
Hi, good morning everyone. I'm Ravi Bhatnagar. I represent a company called Recruitment Geezer, and I head external affairs here. And my second role, I'm the nominee director of DKMS, which is world's biggest bone marrow transplantation company. And in my current role, basically, like, I take care of external affairs and largely the product equity, and we reach around across India with a company which is 150 years old in India. And we have done various campaigns. One of the campaigns, which is the biggest one, is Detol Banega Swachh India. So we reach almost all states in India, and we believe like there's a lot of power in the bottom of pyramid. Like all this, the framework, which is the blueprint, which has been put here, like rigorously we follow that, and we don't differentiate between so-called CSR and the main business. For us, both are same. And about the numbers, like it's 100 million population alone, which is targeted by our program. If you see the company growth, so the numbers and figures are available on the net. So we have just declared our first quarter results for India, which are quite impressive. And with the company, we believe, like my first speaker said, like bottom of the pyramid, don't compromise on the quality. And you know, so when we think about the products for them, we think like we should give them the best. We are the makers of Dettol, Harpic, Lysol, Durex, H-Card, Ring Guard, and many other products. So recently we thought, like, can we have something for these BOP populations where they have the world-class products which can reach them, and which is our niche also. So we collaborated with the companies like the Tagasako and Noozeems. So Noozeems make the enzymes, the Tagasako makes the best of the perfumes, even for the brands like Zinia, Burberry and all. And we are coming up, our global CEO announced 6 months back, we are coming with a best soap solution, which will be a multi-purpose soap. So the soap will be addressing, you know, your cleaning, your laundry cleaning, your bathing, your, you know, it can take care of anything. And then, like we all know, India has huge population which has traditional pit latrines in the rural. And we think, like, you know, there's a strong correlation between health, hygiene and home. Taking that lead, we think, like, it's important to, you know, make India, which is more healthier, more cleaner, and we need to increase the longevity of life of the people. And the basic phenomenon on which we work is, like, we have the brand integration with the company vision and policies along with the national vision. So in light of that, we started it all, Banega Swachh India, and it was small when it started in terms of the number of partners, because partnership is big or small, it depends on, like, who all are the partners and where is the reach. Is it really reaching the last mile? Sometimes we broadly talk about the villages. So villages also are categorized based on the population and the access and reach. In my earlier experiences with the Clinton Health Access Initiative, I have seen very closely, people do reach in the A-class villages, B-class villages, which are quite big, 10,000 plus population. What happened to those which are small hamlets? What happened to those which have populations below 5,000? Most of the businesses tell, like, okay, we can't reach it. Can we have some other solution? Can we reach through the self-help groups? Can we reach through some Mahila Mandals, the women cooperatives, etc., etc.? It's a very fair idea, and we believe, like, in the spirit of partnership, definitely things can be achieved and access can be achieved. I have one gentleman with me here, sitting in front of me, Mr. Pushparaj Kaushik. He's a guy who actually changed the things in Madhya Pradesh, where the ORS, which oral rehydration solution, so, you know, it's there from 1980. And still, you know, children are dying, and India is, you know, number one on the under 5 mortality, arising out of diarrhea and pneumonia. But this is the guy who made the change, and you see the NFHS figures, which is a so-called government data. They also talk about, like, the change has happened. We strongly believe, we have multiple examples, which we are listening from the last 2 days here, and by the virtue of, you know, meeting all of you today here on the dais, we strongly believe as a company we should be more responsible, we are more responsible, and some of the learnings which we will be mutually, you know, agreeing to and sharing, we'll take the things forward. We believe in collaborations, we believe in partnerships, and we have done many big partnerships, and thanks to IntelliCap. So we were, I mean, say a lot of things, but we never knew about, you know, reaching the last 3 billion or 2 billion or 1 billion. So what should be the goal? We were deciding internally, should we reach 100 million, 200 million, 300 million, 400 million? And these guys always challenge us. So boss, this is not the figure. And they not only challenge the so-called CSR or the external affairs or others, they challenge our main business. And then every company needs someone to challenge. Internal stakeholders, the boards and others, and, you know, the very important stakeholders like IntelliCap. So,
thank you, Ravi. So, Mr. Manish, I'd actually like to come to you first. And can you share with our audience the most effective thing you do when it comes to finding the right customers for the products that you're selling?
Yeah, thank you. You know, how do we have built this company, and, you know, how we have grown from the very scratch to the 35 million consumers which we serve today. I just want to give you start with the number on the marketing what we have spent. I don't think we have spent even 2 to 3 crore rupees in all for 8 years on the marketing side, except the collateral and what you see it on the outlet. The best part, I think, you know, what I strongly believe personally is that if you have a need-based products which the consumer needs that, and if that products are available as the distribution level point of view, so there are 2 things are required. One is that the need-based products are available, which you have created, and the consumers, where they need, it is available at the location. Hello. Yeah. So if you achieve these 2 things, then I think, you know, you are reachable. So what we have done is that, you know, we call there's a mantra in our organization. We call that we go behind the queue. What does it mean? Wherever there is a queue, we try to find out why this is a queue. That means there is a need and there is a friction. So if you are able to address these 2 things, where there is a need and you create the product and services around that, so, you know, the name of the company called Suvidha. It's mean conveniency, right? We create a Suvidha basically. We don't have to tell the people that, you know, you have to pay the electricity bill if you want to use it. Or if you have to travel, you have to buy a railway ticket. People know about that. It's only that, you know, you create the convenience instead of going there and standing in the queue for 2 hours, instead of that, it is available now next door. So it's a distribution which you have reached to the people, very close to them, and created need-based products. So these are the two things which we have understood very well, and we work on that.
Pratish, you deal with almost 1,000 customers, from likes of McDonald's and KFCs to the really not so visible ones like the banks and the NBFCs. Where do you think, how important is the marketing message and the strategy to reach out to these customers?
Sure. So, thanks, Ikan. So, as Ikan mentioned, Grab manages logistics not for just the food sector, which includes pretty much the brands which we've normally heard of is McDonald's, KFC, Subway, even the food tech companies such as Zomato or Tiny Owl, but even the e-commerce companies such as Snapdeal, Last Week Bazaar, or a grocery company like Big Bazaar. And what we've seen over these years is there is a change in how these companies are approaching consumers. I think Domino's was the first one to start a revolution of giving you an order at your doorstep in less than 30 minutes. And that mantra and the success behind Domino's was pretty much the same mantra every company in the food tech world used over the last 2 years to say, you know what, if I want to be successful, if I want to garner higher volume, higher market share, I want to promise the consumer that I will give you the product at your doorstep in 30 minutes. Whatever the cost attached to having that logistics done is a separate piece, but in a sense, they always believed, and the food tech industry believes, that the point or the efficiency at which I can move the product from my kitchen to the consumer's doorstep is going to be an equal of my market share. And most, if you see the evolution of working with Zomato, McDonald's, each of them are extremely sensitive to these delivery times. So that's the food tech part. Now the e-commerce part. I think 2 years back, Flipkart, Amazon, Snapdeal, they would be pretty happy delivering a product to you in 2 days, 3 days. As you know, competition intensifies, as you know, differentiators between these giants kind of diminish, the differentiator lies in how quickly can I pass the consumer experience at the doorstep. So 2015 was all about the one-day delivery, that okay, you place an order today, you get the product delivered tomorrow. And each of these companies tied up with us, tied up with companies like Connect India, to create an infrastructure where they can provide deliveries to you within a day. Now in 2016, we see another revolution. As they want to compete better and heavier with the other competitor, they want to deliver the product to you in 4 hours. So most of these e-commerce companies, what they're grappling with in the consumer space is, let's say today, if I'm a consumer, if I want a Gillette shaving cream, I don't go to Snapdeal and place an order. I call up my neighbor Kirana store and he delivers to me in 2 hours time. Chances are Grab is the delivery partner for that Kirana store as well, because I have that model which can satisfy that logistics which can be delivered in a very quick instant time. So each of these companies now want to even buy me, rather than going to Kirana store, we want to create an infrastructure where I, rather than placing a call, I go to Snapdeal on Amazon, and Grab as a logistics company or similar would create a marketplace model picking up from the same Kirana store and delivering to the consumer. So each of these industries, like for example, the Big Bazaar, this is a unique model that they've started with as a pilot in Bangalore, is as a consumer, you go to Big Bazaar, you stand in the aisle, long queue, it's frustrating. They want to add more value. Again, they are competing with the likes of GrowFit, right, the online world. So as an offline client, what they've decided is that once you've picked up a shopping bag, you leave it at the Big Bazaar outlet, and just put a tag that please deliver it to my doorstep. Within the next 3 hours, Grab with its logistics will pick up from Big Bazaar and deliver to your doorstep. So again, it's a convenience. They don't want you to be inconvenient about standing in the queue, picking up a heavy bag, putting it in your car, parking and bringing it back to your doorstep. So as offline and online competes with each other, as online and online competes with each other, each of these B2C companies are going to try to compete. And I think the competition lies in how well you can serve at the last mile. The last example I'll give you on what I see the revolution is, banking. Over the last few years, we've seen a lot of payment gateways, Paytms, and credit card companies wanting to get your subscription to their particular platform. In the past, it was a long, tedious process. You fill up a KYC form, you go to the bank, you mail it. After 7 days, 8 days, you get a confirmation of credit card. Now all of that is changing. Everybody's realized that if you're impulsive about making a decision that yes, you want to subscribe to a credit card, they need to capture that that impulsive decision of yours and convert that into a sale. So to give you an example, we do KYC for some of the banks where when you go onto a website and they say that, you know what, you subscribe to this credit card, you get instant cash back.
The moment you subscribe to that, believe it or not, within 60 minutes, we have an infrastructure which can pick up the KYC form from your doorstep and give you the credit card back in the next 5 days. So it means that from the time you decided it, within 5 days, you have the credit card and doorstep, including KYC form. So these are evolutions which I believe that over the next few years are going to be more robust. People are going to capture more on impulsiveness. And all these consumer-based startups are always going to try to get convenience at the doorstep.